This girl. She's gonna doom them all. Oh.
Multi-body transplant? A surgery to join pieces of 184 bodies?
The children from the plane crash. Their bodies were cut up into pieces, and those pieces were then implanted
in... What?
That boy was Kamui. He's more than one boy now. He has the personalities and body fragments of 184 people, the brains of seven. He's a collective, the sum of...
Get the fuck out. But this is weird, okay?
And yet, somehow he survived and has gone through life with a psychopath that cannot be measured by anyone.
I don't know how.
He lives, but to the scanners and the dominators, he's nothing but a jungle of corpses.
So that's how Kamui does it.
You know, I was going to guess that he was a part of a whole bunch of organs put together. But again, the system, when you identify someone, they know that you existed. So even if you have a little bit of someone here, a little bit of someone there, they'll be able to scan that part and be like, wait, that person is this person, and that eye belongs to that guy, you know? And then the worst part about this is that, wouldn't the system itself be like, yo, if I can't scan this guy, there's a problem, you know?
I sought help from people too, from doctors and counselors I thought I could trust. But as soon as they witnessed my anomaly with their own eyes, they were all out the door. Yes, I can see the dilemma. Working with a person who isn't recognized by Sybil would be a...
Yeah, that's a terrorist. Really?
Why did I have to disappear? I searched high and low.
Really, my guy?
Until finally I found it. It was the season of hell.
What?
Uh-huh. So you do know of it. Well, yes, I've heard of the term, but only vaguely. At one point, the Ministry of Economy proposed a new support system. It was meant to replace Sybil, but it generated controversy. They had chosen to call the system Panopticon, and it would have controlled everything from traffic to the banks and kept a vigilant watch over all of it.
Okay.
That's a building that allows one person to watch everyone inside from a single vantage point. It comes from a prison designed by By observing and recording people's actions and economic activity, it could prevent crimes before they even happened and guide people towards making optimal life choices. It's a relatively simple idea, but some would say that's what makes it ideal. Ideal, huh? To the citizens whose every move is being monitored, that would turn life into a prison, which is different from our current society. How? Let's stay on topic. They started out doing test deployments of Panopticon for traffic surveillance, but as you may be aware, they suddenly began running into all kinds of glitches with it. Yeah, and because of all those complications, the whole Panopticon project was abandoned. Right, and thus Sybil's rule over society has continued unabated up through today. But what if that's exactly what someone wanted to happen? What if everything was arranged to ensure that outcome?
What?
That was a widespread conspiracy theory floating around at the time. Conspiracy theory? You're kidding me. Interference with the Ministry of Economy, manipulation of resources, scrambling for a budget, politicians horse trading. There's no denying that those things happened. In fact, as a direct result of all that, the number of plane crashes and traffic accidents that were occurring was dozens of times higher than in an average year. There were a lot of casualties throughout that period. People would later refer to it as the season of hell. So you found some kind of answer in that mess? I learned everything, and I quickly realized what I needed to do next. So I became a present-day medicine man. It was roughly 5 years ago. That's when I was reunited with him. I had become dependent on drugs due to excessive stress. The cause was plain to see. My mind could no longer bear the heavy burden that comes with being a doctor. It happens more often than you might think. everything for us. He's someone who enables us to dream on a scale we never thought possible.
Overturn everything we know. Sounds like one heck of an endgame.
I see. So that's what this is about. It's not just me you want to judge. You're after the entire civil system itself. Do I have that
okay,
right?
I guess so. Hey, does that mean that he has boobies? And a penis? Maybe he has multiple penises. Why is it this is the things I think about? Mika.
Okay, well, we shouldn't waste time. Let's give our latest status reports and make sure we're all on the same page. Right, I can go first. I did a search for anyone who shares the same name with a victim from the plane crash. There are 54 matches just in the central city. There's always the possibility that... No, I think we have to stay with our theory that all 184 victims are being used as hollow disguises. And that Conway has been the one wearing those hollows each time. Yes. That therapist who spoke with Kitazawa, the pharmacist from the mental care facility, and the hostage from the...
Yeah, touché.
Each one was Conway.
Well, it's something. It's a big list, but maybe he only uses these hollows. At least that would narrow it down.
I agree. Conway's obsessed with the crash and the victims that became part of him. We can use that. It's better than him disguising at random.
In that sense, his true face has been revealed to us.
Your turn, Mr. Dinasa.
We analyzed the organs found in his hideout. And from that, we got a list of people who were possibly swapped. They're all big shots from every sector of society.
This is Dr. Masazaki's work. He's the one responsible for replacing those powerful people with imposters. He admitted it himself.
He killed each one while pretending to offer treatment. And to think during all those horrific acts, he was still able to keep his psychopaths clear.
That's the unique talent Conway possesses. Between his therapy and his drug compounding, he can clear the psychopaths of the most violent criminals despite their actions. You could almost call it brainwashing.
So medical care is his biggest weapon. That's troublesome.
At the same time, his attacks have all been limited to medical institutions. Remember Kitazawa? What he admitted during his interrogation?
Yeah, he said he targeted that big drug maker, I think.
And then the hostage incident with Aoyanagi. That happened at a mental health facility.
Yeah, but why the port? Of all places, why would he hide out there? There must be some advantage we're missing.
What could it be? Miss Kinesica, are there any open missing person cases filed in the last several months?
I don't think I've seen anything in the record lately, no.
That's weird. Because some people have clearly gone missing.
Yeah, you're right. If these people are assuming the identities of the organ victims, they would have to disappear from their own lives at the same time.
Unreported. That suggests that people's society wouldn't notice it disappeared. Hold on. I remember seeing foreign newspapers and currency scattered in the hideout.
What if they were foreign workers? So all the impersonators are actually just illegal
immigrants?
That's a real possibility.
What does he gain by going that far?
What? Sure.
And what do you want? Can you afford to be loafing around the office like this? I didn't come to see you because I have too much free time. I've actually been interested in you for a while. Joji Saga, the notorious teacher who turned his students black.
What?
That's nice to say. Controlling people's psychopaths. Quite an achievement. Doesn't seem like the type of skill that can be learned. Indeed, if something that potentially powerful could be taught and spread around willy-nilly, society would collapse. Well, if it's not a skill, then it's something you were born with. You have a rare talent for clouding people's psychopaths. It's the exact opposite of Kamui's ability to clear them. You want me to say I'm honored or something? And because of your gift, you're dependent on Inspector Tsunamori, whose psychopath doesn't change when you interact with her. Seems like a big need. Oh?
Excuse me.
Understood. I'm dependent. And what does that make you? You're a sharp guy,
wow.
Professor.
Touche.
Several of the company's patented technologies were used to perform his surgery after the plane crash.
Maybe he's dying?
A procedure for extracting a brain while the donor's still alive, and one for joining brains together. Why would they take out patents on techniques like these? Let's see related files. Fully automated brain extraction by a drone.
Oh, gave me the wheelies.
What? She died 5 years ago.
His classified? What? The information is classified. She figured something out.
Well, that was a bust.
Yeah. I was really hoping to check out each of those impersonators one by one, but...
There's nothing we could have done. We're a beat behind. An alarm? What's that about?
The weight sensor I set up on the floor of my apartment went off.
What? Whoa.
I was checking the smoke detector and sprinkler system. Since you're so busy, you signed a paper allowing us to come in with the manager's key, or at least...
Yeah, right.
Maybe I'm wrong.
Is that true?
Well, that's a surprise. You left that graffiti on your wall.
It's not like it's doing me any harm.
Or is it?
Thanks, glad you think so.
It means that you lack charm, Inspector.
It's a PSD alert. Wait, Grandma.
Oh.
Due to the alarm at your home, the security level for Aoi Tsunamori, currently in protective custody, has been elevated to level
1. What?
Oh, well, that's,
Grandmother.
Huh?
Ugh. She propelled her research forward using Conway as well as the deceased plane crash victim's body.
Wow.
As a result, the Foundation's proprietary technology continues to evolve. Kirito Conway's goal in his crimes is to retaliate against the Token A Foundation. We can hasten his arrest by maintaining a close watch on the Foundation. However, Division 1's ability to function is currently hampered by problematic elements. Namely, Akane Tsunamori and Sakuya Togane. Sakuya Togane was born out of his mother Misako Togane's experiments to create the AA phenomenon.
Yeah.
We can speculate that his laboratory beginnings are what allowed for him to carry the worst crime coefficient on record. What all this means, then, is that Kamui, the ringleader of the crime, and Sakuya Togane are connected by the key word
AA. Oh.
I anticipate that with Sakuya Togane's influence, Inspector Tsunamori's crime coefficient will follow suit and increase as well. However, Inspector Tsunamori does not seem to care, nor is she listening to the advice of others. This is a serious situation. Many inspectors and enforcers have already died or suffered injury as a result of Inspector Tsunamori's decision-making. As it stands, we can't arrest Togane.
Ooh. Oh, but yo, you can't do that. The symbol system is not gonna go. Oh no, she is dead. Mika, run, hide. You're dead. You gone goof. You're dead. Oh God. They're gonna. Oh no, not good for her. This is not gonna be good for her. No. Oh no, oh no, 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 no.
You sound as if you figured out what Kamui's goal might actually be. With the trust of Matsuzaki, Kamui hopes to ignite a revolution. And in order to overthrow the society, he's judging the entity that embodies it most. There's only one such entity that fits.
Ooh.
It's the civil system.
Okay. Oh. Oh my God, no!
By the way, about this double A, this is something we refer to as open door data. And what's open door data? It's a trap made to lure in and understand those who are unfit for society and who would try to explore
girl.
The secrets. And your little feet got caught.
Wow.
Right in. Double A stands for the phrase a priori acquit. It means being born criminally alien.
Oh.
What? Now then, since you've deviated from the investigation and spent your time collecting data like this instead, what shall I
do? No! Oh no!
To think this led to just a small change in your psychopath.
What is this?
I bet we can still put it to good use. How about letting me take care
of
it?
Oh. Did he just say mother? Yo, I was just about to speculate that!
Do whatever you like, son. I can handle her anytime I wish. She's not our real problem.
If you're talking about Tsunamori and Kamui, don't worry. I'll bring them both down as quickly as
possible. Oh my God!
After all, Mother, it's my life's mission to make sure you and Sybil are beautiful and pure.
What are you even talking about? No,
nothing! Ah! I love her! I love her! I heard.
No, no,
oh God. Oh no.
A wise choice, Inspector. You really are an ideal citizen for this society. So ideal, you're boring.
Her reaction. It could serve as a test case for how the public will react to our reveal of the system.
Well, why don't we try to?
Oh no. Oh no!
Inspector Shimonsky, we're going to tell you the secret behind our world.
Oh no!
Here, I want the power, the fortune, and fame. But I'm running in a marathon with a torch and a rain. I'm just a pawn in the game. They're saying off with his brain. I'm going insane, losing my mind in the illusion of time. And this life is up to you to decide. I'm gassed up, yup, Jupiter high. Self-esteem gets my train of thought rolling. Now this logo's in motion.